A very good morning, everyone. Thank you so much for taking your Saturday morning. At Indonesia right now is 9 a.m. while at Singapore now is 10 a.m. My name is Puspita from Vivi Stop Orchard Singapore, and together with me, my colleague JK as your host. Yeah, I'm very happy and excited because, like, you know, we have friends from Indonesia, we have friends from Japan who are currently in Singapore, Arena, and we have friends from Medan, Indonesia. So for our agenda for today, right, in a moment's time, the Klub Hobi teams will be sharing with us their creative journey and experience from their professional perspective. What is it like to be a landscape designers and agriculturist? And learn more about the process, how designing a garden or landscape is like. And during the sessions, if you have any questions, feel free to unmute yourself and ask question. And or what you can do, you can type in the group chat as well. Yeah, and then we will have a very short pop quiz. Yeah, and then after that, we will get our hands dirty by having a creative time making our dream garden in the dream garden projects. So as mentioned earlier, you can use any medium. So so we do not want to restrict you only drawing or painting. You can, if you...
Can we do Tinkercad?
Yes, you can use Tinkercad. So for some of you who don't know what is Tinkercad, Tinkercad is actually a 3D software where you can build 3D modelings. Yeah. And then during the making times, if you have any questions, feel free to ask. Okay. So then 15 minutes before the sessions end, we thought of, like, it would be fun to have everybody share their process or progress. Don't worry, you don't have to finish your projects by the end of the sessions. You could take your time and during the sharing session, you can just share with us, like, what you're making. I know some of you might have concern like speaking in public. Don't worry, we are here to inspire with each other, and we will not judge, but instead of we get to learn from each other. Yeah. I'll share a little bit more about the community wall later on. So, and then last but not least, we will have photo taking together to commemorate the session. Yay! So, before I hand over this session to my to Klub Hobi teams, I'd like to properly introduce them. Okay. So, Klub Hobi is a creative collective based in Indonesia, founded in mid-2021. Which is just recently by a good three good friends, Ami, Salsa, and Putti. And Klub Hobi has mission to provide a space for everyone to draw and make friends while celebrating the joy of creating with no pressure, no stress, and no worry. So the community here, they have an Instagram page. If you are on Instagram, you can follow them by adding them at Klub Hobi. And then, right, so for this, for the community meets every Friday night, every 2 weeks, online. And then during the session, we will be given a so-called creative challenge where we could, again, like, express our creativity by using drawing or using any medium. So, like, last week, what they did, they were work, because it's a season of Halloween, so they were working on a Halloween themes. Yeah, so here you go. So without further ado, I'd like to pass on to Klub Hobi teams. Yeah.
Okay, thank you, Puspita, for introducing about Klub Hobi. And now, for everyone, thank you for joining today's session. We are so happy to meet new friends. And now we want to introduce ourselves. So from me, my name is Putti. I'm from Indonesia. Now currently I live in Bogor, Indonesia. And I work as a designer and communicator in a construction company. I love to draw and making new friends. And next we have Ami.
Hello guys, I'm Ami and now I work as a landscape supervisor and I love to make and DIY things. And next, my friend Salsa.
Hello guys, my name is Salsa. I'm currently working as a regulatory staff, different from two of my friends. I love cats and do anything fun. Now I live in Jakarta, Indonesia. Nice to meet you all.
To meet you.
You.
Okay, next. Okay, on today's session, we are going to make our garden design. But first thing first, now let's talk about landscape. Like, as we know, landscape is everything we can see outside our house. What come into your mind when you heard the word landscape? Like in this picture, we have three pictures here, and these pictures are part of landscape. A landscape is part of the earth surface that can be viewed at one time from one place. And for example, here we have a mountainous landscape, which has a lake and a mountain and a forest. And when we go to the city like Singapore, we can see the cityscape where we can see the high-rise building and the city lights. And when we are in our house, maybe we can see our garden as the small landscape in our house. We can go next. So these are two types of landscape based on how it's created and how big it is. Landscape actually, based on how it's created, have natural and artificial, and based on how big is the landscape, divide into three types. It's micro, meso, and macro scale. Next. Now, based on how it's created, landscape has two types. It is natural landscape and artificial landscape. In natural landscape, we have this example of valley. It's a river with the hills beside the river. And for the artificial landscape, the example is garden, which we will make it today. Garden. Next. Landscape scale, based on how big it is divided into three groups. It's micro scale, meso scale, and macro scale. Micro scale is the example is home garden, like we have the garden in our house. Because the size is so small, we call it micro scale landscape. Also, where you can see the park near your house or the small park near the road, it also called micro scale landscape because it's very small. In the meso scale, it's like a medium scale. We can call it the meso scale landscape. The example is city park or the golf yard. The example is if you ever heard about Central Park in New York. And the last is the macro scale, which is the size is very big. We call it a national park. The example is Komodo National Park in Indonesia. It's very big because it is the place for one animal to live. It's a habitat of the animal called Komodo. So it's called national park and it is a macro scale landscape. Next. So yeah, as we know, we live in the tropical area of the earth. So we have a landscape called tropical landscape, which have the characteristic is first, lush is the plants on the tropical area has a lot of greenery, a lot of leaves, and also have a colorful flower and colorful the other part of the tree, and have a variety growth form. So the plants not only grow from the soil, but also they can grow with another plant. Like this one is they have hanging on other trees. And then we in the tropical landscape also have water elements landscape with the plants who can grow with a lot of water, like a lotus, and some we can see the example next on the slide. And then level is the plant has so many level of height, from the very short one like grass until the very high trees, like above 5 meter trees. Next. So why we talk about plants and how important are plants in a garden? Then the first, the plants can make us comfortable and to fix air quality. For example, when you walk into a park or a garden and you see a lot of trees, we can feel comfortable, right? They can protect us from the sun and give us a fresh air. And plants also can use for aesthetical purpose. For example, with the different type of color in the flower, it can make the garden more beautiful and more colorful. So next is architecture purpose. A lot of plants can use to have a function as like the architectural structure. For example, like the screen here, the yellowish tall trees here, this is can be used as a wall to divide the area, this garden. And this has a car, I call it a parking lot. So this this is to divide between the garden and the parking area. So yeah, it has an architectural purpose as a wall or a screen between the garden and the parking area. That's one of the example. And next. Okay, this is will be explained by Ami.
Okay guys, we move to how to choose the plant for our garden. Next. Plant based on area, there are two area. First, highland, and the second one, lowland area. The highland area above 700 meters above sea level, and most of the highland plants are the plants with a flower plant and have a bright color of their flower, and or the plant with a green and big leaf. For example, for the highland plants are there are hydrangea with their purple flower and gladiolus with their colorful flower. And second, lowland plants. Most of the lowland plants are plants with the bright colors of their flower or leaf. We can see the example of the lowland plants like adenium with their colorful flower and bromelia with their colorful leaf. Okay, next. And this plant based on the sunlight. There are three themes based on the sunlight. The first is sunny theme, the second is filter theme, and the third is steady theme. The sunny theme is the full direct sun plant. This plant needs sunlight every day, especially flower plants and the plants with colorful leaves. They need sunlight to grow and have a bright color. For example of the sunny theme are bougainville with their purple flower, and second one is cordyline with their purple leaf, and portulaca with the colorful flower too. Second, the filter theme. Filter theme plants, we can see the area under the tree or area without the direct sun is the perfect area for the filter theme, because they don't need too much sunlight for growing, just around 50% of the sunlight. The example of the filter theme are their aglaonema with the green leaf and calathea tricolor with the three color of the leaf, and the last is asparagus. And the third, there are shady theme. The plants that only need a little sunlight for growing. For example, the indoor plants. If they get too much sunlight, it makes them burn. Here the example of the shady theme. There are Spatipilum, Asplenium medus, and Begonia with their polka dot leaf. Okay, next. Okay, this plan based on water intensity. First, non-intensive, we have an example, cactus or Carnegie gigante. In their habitat, this plant can live for months without water. The habitat of this plant is dry, rocky, and desert area. If you plant this plant in your garden, you can water it once every 2 weeks. Too much water can make them die. The second is semi-intensive. This is the example is Sansevieria flowers. Watering plant is done to maintain soil moisturized evenly. You can water it once every 3 days. And the third is intensive. We have an example, peperomia plant. Intensive watering usually for indoor plant. Watering once every 2 days. And last, wet. Aquatic plants fall into this category. Plants are placed in water or pots in a saturated state. Here example, the nymphaea lotus. Next. And this is the type of plant based on how they grow. There are grass, ground cover, shrub, tree, climber plants, epiphyte, and hemi-epiphyte. The grass have a function for covering the lane or the ground, and the grass grow without hard stem. The second is ground cover, have some function with grass to cover the lane, but the ground cover, they have a hard stem and some of them have a flowers. The ground cover plant has many branches and canopy cover the ground, and their height less than 1/2 meter. The third, there are the shrubs. Shrubs, no main stem, have many branches and up to 3 meter height, and they have many functions such as a border, the barrier, and the screen. Next, the tree. Tree has a stem, height above 5 meters, and plant with elongated stem or trunk and supporting branches and leaf in most species. Next, climber plant. This plant needs other plants or objects to get the best position in the competition for sunlight. Climber plant live at the bottom on the forest, so they get very little sunlight, and because the stem is weak, it has developed some special organs such as tendrils, spines, or aerial roots to help it survive by stick on other taller and stronger structure. Next, epiphyte. Epiphyte are different from the parasite plant in that they grow on other plants for cycle support and do not necessarily affect the host negatively. Just stick on the other plant. Hemi-epiphyte. Hemi-epiphyte plant that start out like epiphyte, then their roots extend into the soil to support the canopy and to take in water and nutrition. Their root can heal other plants. Next. This is plant based on their function. Their ground cover, border, barrier, screen, and display plant. The ground cover same with the slide, function to covering the lane and to decoration of your garden too. And the second one is border. The border plan is this picture. We can use a border to put a boundary between the road and the lawn. The third, barrier. If you want to make your home garden more natural, you can use the barrier plants to be the fence. And the screen plant, if we want to cover some bad view, for example, parking area, road, and we can use the screening plant. For example, in this picture is Song of Jamaica plant, or we can call it Dracaena reflexa. And the last is display plant. The display plant, as an interesting point in the garden with their colorful leaf or their colorful flower or texture. Next. Okay, thank you, Ami. Next, we're gonna talk about the friends and enemies of our plants. Next, to take care of our garden, we must pay attention to the environment around our garden. All the living and unliving things could give a bad or good contribution to our garden. So our garden contains with biotic and abiotic components. The biotic, we often call it as a living things, such as an insect, microorganism, or fungi that we often call it a mushroom. And the abiotic, such as a water, the sunlight, the wind, or the soil. Next. So in this circle, here is our garden. Our garden contains with a good team and a bad team. What is the good team? Good team is anything that gives benefits to our garden, such as a beneficiary insects, the fertilizer. As you can see this, the ladybug is eating the pest. It can help us to manage our plants, okay. And the bad team is anything that have a potential to harm our garden, such as a caterpillar or a toxic compound. Why did I put the bad team inside the good team? Because bad team sometimes come from the good team. It turned out bad in a certain condition, such as excessive population or dosage. Next. So here's another example for good team and bad team. The grasshopper or locust sometimes can help us maintain the natural balance of our garden ecosystem. Meanwhile, the excessive amount of grasshoppers can cause the extensive damage of our plant. They can eat all of the leaf and make the plant die. And the other example is organic or chemical compounds such as fertilizer or pesticides. Somehow, it is good for our plants if we applied it according to the recommendation dosage. Just like us, the human, we often eat the medicine and vitamin to help us to be healthier and boost our immunity. But if we consume it too much, it will damage our body. Next.
Now let's talk about design. Next. So in designing a garden, we have these 6 elements that we can use to design our garden. Next. The first one is focal point. Focal point is like the main focus of the garden, which it has to be stand out with have different kind of element that it make it the focus on the garden. Next, we have the example. We have this example of the garden, and this round shape is the focal point because it has different shape from the surrounding. It has a round shape while the surrounding is a lot of rectangular or square shape. So it make this circle is more stand out around the garden surround itself. Next. The second one is line. Line in the garden, we can make it as a borders and circulation. Borders is like the border on our garden that divide this our garden and outside space of the garden, and the circulation is the pathways or the way the visitor can walking through the garden where they can enter and exit the garden. It's called circulation. Next. So in this example, this is the border is in the in the edge of the garden, like these plants. Plants the and the circulation is this row, the red row. It's circulation. It let the visitor walking through the garden. Next, shape. In garden, we can use so many shape that we want. For example, like this triangle, round, rectangular, or anything, we can create the shape inside our garden. Next, for the example, in this garden, we can see the square, the rectangular, the round shape. We can put everywhere in the garden, so it make the balance and make the garden feels nice. And next, the scale. The scale is the different kind of size in the garden. As we can see in the example, we can see the high tree and the medium size of plants, which has the same size as our cat, maybe, something like that. So we can use so many kind of plants that have different size in our garden. Next, for the example, in this garden, we can use the grass, the medium size of plants, and then the high trees to create the shading, so it can protect us from the sun, so it can be more comfortable in the garden. Next, the texture. In the garden, we can see a lot two type of texture. We know it have a soft texture and hard texture. We call it also softscape and hardscape. The softscape is represented by the plants and the water. The plants is make the soft texture in the garden, while the pavement, where it's made from the rock or the asphalt, is called hardscape in the garden. Next. In this garden, we can see the soft texture is on the plants, and also this one in the center of the round shape here, this water, we can call it soft texture or softscape, while the hardscape is the pavement or the road where people can walk into the road, the pavement on the garden. Next, and the colors. We can add so many colors in our garden. It can come from the different color of the plants, like the flower or the leaf. Next. In this garden, you can find a lot of color, from the dark green, the yellowish one, and the pink flower, and warm brown from like the soil. So we can use so many color and use the elements of the garden. We can make our garden more colorful. Next. So now this is the design process of the garden. First, when someone asks you or you want to make the garden, so you accept the challenge. Okay, let's do this. And then you have to visit the site doing the research, like collect information, how is the site condition, and next, we have to analyze the good side, the good point and bad point of the site. How can we make the most of the good point and overcome the bad point of the site? Like, for example, in our site, we have a good point with the good view on the mountain. We can make the sitting area that facing the mountain, so it will be the good point of our landscape. While the bad points, for example, like the parking area or the in the garden, there is a bad view that we want not to see it. We can list them as the bad point, and then. For in the next step, the design concept, we can visualize our idea into some sketch. Next. Now, this is a concept diagram or some example that can be used while sketching the idea of your garden. Like this is the row for make the circulation line, or you can define where the people enter the garden, where should be the route to enjoy the garden. And then on this star, like this sign is like to identify the focal point or the main focus or the main attraction of the garden or the park. And then this shape, square shape, is this like make the apa ya, the border of the your side, the garden. Like my garden is this shape like this, or you can define your own shape of the garden. Okay, next. This is the symbol to define the form of the plants. Like this one is for ground cover, and this one is for bush or the shrub, and the round one is the for the tree. Like this, we can have so many kind of tree. This is like palm trees, the big trees, the regular trees, and something like that. Oh yes, and then next we have the example again. Now, this is the usual step of making our garden. So it first come from the base map. This the base map is the existing condition of the site we want to build or we want to design. And we make the concept diagram by adding a lot of symbol on the previous slide with symbol. This is, oh, I want to put the plants near the river. I want to put the border plants near the river. And I want people walk into this path to enjoy the garden, something like that. So you add a lot of symbols. You can make plants or the pathways in circulation like that. And next, in the site plan is the more, we can more render it into the site plan. We have draw the trees, what kind of trees, and then give the color on the tree, on the pathway, on the river, so something like that. This is like the finish step of the designing process of the landscape. Next. Yeah, on the design development is add some element and make a site plan is the process in design development. And after the site plan finish, we can move to the construction process, which is this is the actual process of the landscape, not only design it, but actually build it on the site for real. Okay, next.
Okay, next, this is an example of what we're gonna make today. So this is made by Ami, a site plan and perspective view of the garden. This is a 3D design, but actually you can make with just a sketch, like the next slide, please. You can make it like this also using a marker or using anything, what of your favorite tools and materials. And the most important is you have to do it happily, no pressure, and hassle-free, okay? You can draw it as a sketch, put it some colors, or just black and white, it's up to you. Okay.
Yeah. For example, like if you have a small space in your house and you are thinking about, I want to make this small space into a lovely little garden, it's okay, it's also okay. And also if you want to do it like we are in Halloween season, right? So if you want to decorate it with Halloween theme, it's also okay. So the theme is up to you. Okay. Next.
Thank you for Klub Hobi teams for sharing. I know everyone, there are a lot of knowledge and things to absorb. So before we go to the next topic, do you have any questions for the team? Everybody's good? All right. So if you have any questions, right, I know that like even for me myself, right, I'm a new beginner when it comes to landscape designer. So I might go back to the slide later on again to check. So I will go through a little bit later on. So Tim, you would like to continue to the next session?
Yeah.
Okay, guys. Get ready. We are going to have pop quiz. So it's going to be a multiple choice. So what you can do, right? You can type in the chat as well. Okay. So yeah.
So this is the first quiz. So which one do you think is damaged by the locust?
Or grasshopper?
We often call it a grasshopper. Is it the first picture or the second one? Which one do you think is bite by a locust? If you want to answer, you can raise your hands or put the answers on the chat box. So sorry. Anyone has an answer for this question? The first question? Jun Kang say it's the second one. Anyone wants to answer it? We can see the difference here that the first picture, there is a... Candice is... answering the number one. The first picture, we can see the unique pattern like a circle, and the second picture we can see it's also a circle, but it started to eat from the edge of the leaf, and the first picture is eaten from the center of the leaves. Okay, maybe we can jump right to the answer. Okay.
All right.
So the answer is 2. As you can see here, the locust or grasshopper, sometimes they often eat from the edge of the leaves. And the first picture is damaged by a caterpillar called a pagoda backworm. You can see this is... their house looks like a pagoda, and they eat in a very unique shape. It is a very good circle like that.
Looks like a pattern.
Yeah, like a pattern in the leaves.
Yes.
Okay, the next question. Okay. What kind of plants is this based on its function? What do you think, guys? Is it a border plants or a ground cover plants or maybe a display plants? As we can see here, the color is so
bright,
so beautiful, right? Yeah, it's so bright. And what do you think type of plant is this?
You can just make a guess.
Okay. Maybe Amit wants to describe the answer. Oh, Candice is answering C.
Yeah. The next the answer of this question. The answer is. Ding 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 ding. This is a display plant because they have a colorful bright color, bright color, and inter function as a decoration of your garden and be point of interest in your garden too.
Okay. Next question, please. Okay. Among these four plants, what do you think is belong to the sunny team? Which plant do you think that really like to the sunlight? The plant that we often put it in a outdoor area, which can light by the sun directly.
The clue is they have colorful flowers.
Colorful flowers.
Colorful leaves.
Not only green leaf.
Maybe it's quite hard.
So answer with A. So
the right answer is
D. Oh yeah, it has colorful flower. Colorful leaf.
Good try, Jim.
The last question, please. Which one is an example of a hardscape? I think it's quite easy.
Obvious, guys. Those of you who have not answered any question, Irena, Noi.
You can just guess the answer.
So,
and the clues?
B, the leaf. The C is this stone pathway. D is this like
plant.
A grand cover, I think.
Yeah. Okay.
Candice is answering C. Yeah. Irina is C too. Okay. The answer is?
The
answer is?
Yeah. Because it is a rock pavement, and the other A, B, and D are plants with is a soft skin. So they have soft texture. Okay.
Thank you for the participation.
Everyone. So for those who have got the answer correctly, thank you so much for the participation, but there's no gift. In a moment's time, we are gonna have the times to share, to do our own making. And then later on, I would like to invite everyone to kind of like share your progress here in this community wall, or you can do it later on as well, up to you. This is actually a Padlet. Is the way that you use it is super easy by just clicking on this add pause. And then over here is if you have taken a photo, you can just submit or you can just take a photo together with your artwork as well. So what we can do later on, you can add your names, the title of your work, and then plus the medium that you're using. So, and then plus a little bit about your masterpiece. All right. So I'm going to stop sharing my screen. Okay. So if you don't have any more questions, we're going to take this time to start making, right? Yeah.
May I ask what media or tools did you use for this design? Okay.
We would like to know what you guys are. So for example, me are using my sketchbook and my watercolor.
I'm just going to use technology.
Wow, that's great.
Yeah, Eli is going to use Tinkercad.
I'm using a sketchbook too and a watercolor.
Me too.
Okay.
Sketchbook.
Manual. How about Jun Kang, JK?
I'm using Minecraft.
Minecraft, wow, awesome. Right, yeah. Minecraft, if any of you are Roblox fans or Minecraft, feel free to use that medium as well. How about Arena?
I'm gonna draw.
Are you gonna draw? Okay. Like what Puti said earlier, right? The theme is really up to you. It can be imaginary landscape, right, Puti? And then it can be also like your dream garden at your house. Or I thought of maybe like reimagining garden around you. Yeah. And there's friends from Singapore as well. There's so many garden around. If there's some garden that you think that can be improved, you can create that as well. How about candies? And Ifaldo?
I'm still thinking about the design.
Okay, still thinking about the design. Sure, sure, take your time.
Like Salsa want to share Ava the her video of making her piece.
So this is a small triangle garden. As you can see, there are design elements here. There are a focal point, a border plan. Sorry. And this is, I want to highlight the design element. Focal point, the bad point, and how to overcome the bad point and make
so you have like the garden facing the mountain I see on your drawing.
Yeah.
That's a good point.
Do you guys have done your sketch?
I haven't, Salsa.
Not yet.
Not yet.
I want to ask Salsa, so what inspired you to create this triangle garden?
I inspired by a small garden in the city. You know, sometimes there are small space in the city that has a unique shape like that. So maybe people would like to come here to just enjoy the city or having a quiet moment for them like that.
Yeah, yeah. So earlier when you mentioned about four good point and bad point from your drawings, right? Could you share a little bit more?
Okay. The bad point is, just like Puti asked, there's a parking lot near the garden. So So I want to put some border plants that has maybe with a good color of flowers, and put that near the parking lot. Mm. And then the good point is this garden is located near the river and can and it has a hill views, which is so good to be seen. And I put some bench that plays directly to the hill views, like that. Hills and a river, a small river.
Okay, I like it when you mention, like, when you see this is the bad point, you see it as a problem, but then how we can have a creative problem solving, like instead of remove all this parking lot area, but how we can beautify this parking lot area as well.
Yeah. Instead of building a wall, maybe we can put a barrier plants that have an interesting colors, so it will be more beautiful, I think.
Yeah, I agree.
Or maybe we can build a wall and put a plant that can grow in the wall.
Yeah, like the climber plants,
yeah,
right?
Climber plants, yes. And also I inspired by the garden, the small garden in my university. So my university is mostly content with a triangle shape like that. So there are a garden with this shape also.
Maybe I share first. I'm not really completed, but the general idea is there.
Yeah, yeah.
Wait, can y'all see my Minecraft?
Anyone else here playing Minecraft?
I used to play when I was little.
Okay. So basically, over here, let's say when I get into the house, okay, and then there's this glass roof.
Wow.
Yeah, so over here, I'll some plants over here, then you'll grow because of sun. Okay, then over here, it's like I'll put plants that don't need sun, like I think if I'm wrong, cactus. I think cactus need sun. Yeah. Then there's level 2 for more planting. I'll be planting at the sides because over here, like, need let sunlight go through. Yeah. Then once this part is done, it's outside. It's like the outdoor garden. So over here is supposed to be like a water fountain kind of thing. Yeah. I'm supposed to have a water fountain, but I didn't have time to finish it. We're gonna finish another day when I'm free. Yeah, then that's about it. Yeah.
Thank you, Chun Kang.
Thank you. It's so dream garden. I want to have a fountain too in my house, but my house too small.
You can have mini fountain.
Yes.
What will you call this garden?
The name of my garden.
Yeah, and your house.
How about we name it together? I have no idea what name to give it.
If anyone has any suggestion, feel free to share with Chun Kang. For me, when I see it, it reminds me of Bali for whatever reason. Like, it looks like, I don't know. Like, you know, like the surrounded, it looks like the rice place, yeah, where people plant some Bali rice. I don't know. It's like a villa in the midst of Bali. Ah, I miss travel.
Hmm. Yeah, then we will call it Bali then.
No.
Bali.
Mm. I would like to ask the team some question, if you don't mind. For this lens, I know that you guys doing landscape as a, you are working as landscape designer professional. How long does it take to, you know, from the beginning till the end, finish this one project?
Me as a landscape supervisor in botanical garden in Bogor. I think Ami knows more. Ami, please. Like, berapa lama kayak proses dari desain sampai realizes apa membangun taman gitu ya, Mi?
Mata aku hilang ya?
enggak.
From the, it's about, I think maybe 1 month from the first we site visiting and make a concept, design, and then building. 1 or 2 months maybe. It's defined to, if you use more hardscape for your garden, it can take a long time. But if you just plant many plants and petugasnya banyak gitu, mungkin maybe you can finish faster. Mm. And in my office, like because I work at the Bogor Palace, and there are Mr. President there, and we cannot work every time. When the Mr. President is there, we cannot do any work, and it handles and need a long time to finish your work. Like that.
So the fun fact is Ami is working in the Bogor Palace, right?
Yeah.
For, as a garden supervisor. Yeah. landscape supervisor.
Oh, okay. So Bogor Palace is where Mr. Jokowi or our Indonesian presidents live, right?
Yes.
Wow. Yeah, so good. It's like it's a Istana in Dobby God, guys. It's where the president lives. Yeah. Wow, so amazing. But I'm surprised that like it takes only 1 to 2 months to finish a garden. Wow.
Yeah, that small garden, not a meso, not meso scale. It's a micro scale.
Yeah, okay. So during the process, what was the fun process time for you, Ami?
Fun process. When you plan the plan, I think it near to the finish step, and you can see the your design is grilling and makes your feeling fun and happy too, because it will be finished soon.
Mm. So you are the designer, and then there will be another team who will be constructing the garden, or you also have to be part of the constructing team?
Oh, the team to building the garden, I just supervisor of the work.
Mm. He is the boss.
And the maintenance too.
Wow.
Because we have a deer rusa di sana.
A deer? Oh, wow.
Yeah. Sebagai hama, asal hama, apa asal kalau rusa.
So the deer will eat the plant,
yeah,
that Ami has built.
Yeah.
You kind of have to chase them away.
No, because they mereka kayak semacam aset negara gitu, jadi dilindungi. It's okay to eat our plan. We can plan again.
Okay. So right. What Ami said, right. So they have deers around the Istana Bogor garden, yeah. And then these deers, right, considered as pest to them.
Yeah.
The pest. Because they keep eating the plants, but they cannot do anything because it's a protected animals.
Yeah.
Wow. You can only find deers in the zoo here in Singapore.
There are 600 or 500 maybe of deers there.
400.
Population, yeah. 500, I think.
Oh, there's a lot.
Overpopulation, I think.
If you have any question, feel free to ask. Otherwise, I will be asking another question. Ha ha ha. So suppose our friends here have are inspired to be the, you know, like landscape designer. What will you advise to them? Like, what is the first step we can take?
Yeah, actually, yeah. Based on what I see now, is degree is not that important. Yeah, but you can learn first, like if you now still in the middle school, yeah, or elementary school, maybe you can, if you like plants, you can explore so many plants, like because on our friends with the profession of landscape architects know the plants so well, so I think the knowledge of plants will be a great advantage if you want to pursue your career in landscape design or landscape architecture. Yeah, I mean, yeah.
Yeah.
The knowledge of the
plants. So like architecture at the same time, getting to know about the plants and landscape.
Yeah. So yeah. Far, the specific major of landscape architects, I think in Indonesia it's still limited, yeah, still limited major, but you can also enter from like architecture and then try to learn deeper about plants and then you can be landscape architect. Ya kan, Amy, ya? So like from me and Ami are from landscape architecture major, so yeah, we learn a lot about plants and agriculture. And also a little bit of construction design is selected.
You guys have to do like residential landscape as well, like housing area.
Yeah, so we learn a lot of scale of landscape from the housing area. And also from the large agricultural area, like in Bali, you mentioned before, we learn about what plants are good to combine with the rice field, surrounding the rice field with the local plants. Ya, belajar banyak itu sih, Kak, tentang kayak budaya menanam, sebut bahan kayak sampai kayak gitu. Tentang budaya, terus tanaman-tanaman yang biasa dipakai orang-orang lokal gitu. Jadi sangat luas sebenarnya.
So heritage landscape.
Ya, yeah, heritage landscape, cultural landscape.
Wow, yeah. I guess in Singapore, I can't remember if we have heritage or cultural landscape.
I think the Singapore Botanical Garden is one of the heritage landscape.
Is that... When you mention cultural or heritage, oh, which means there are some part of the garden that symbolize Singapore in that sense?
Yeah, it contributes to the history of the Singapore. Like in the Bogor Botanical Garden, it has a history background. Like when we are under the British, penjajahan British, yeah, there's a place for the British people to istirahat di Bogor untuk kayak gimana nih sejarahnya
mereka bikin semacam kebun untuk percobaan gitu.
Kebun percobaan ya. Penelitian gitu ya.
So maybe to collect the biodiversity from Indonesia, they put it in the botanical garden as a research.
Okay. Yeah, I know that in Singapore there is orchid garden. Eli, you ready to share?
Yeah, what? Huh?
Would you like to share your
Okay, give me one minute. Let me fix something. 1 minute.
Yeah. Okay. There's blood box.
Tinggal berapa menit lagi, Kak? We need to share our progress.
Yes, 11:43 now, guys. Thanks, Ami, for the reminder. we left in 15 minutes, guys. Time passed so fast. So what you can do, we will take turns to share, or if you like, I share in the group chat, right? This you can click on the Padlet and upload your picture as well. Yeah, I'm gonna give for example.
Okay, can I share now?
Yep. Hold on. Ooh.
Wow,
that's
so good.
Wow. What is the name of your garden?
I don't know.
Rocky Garden.
Rocky Hills.
Rocky Hills. Yeah, that sounds good. Rocky Hills.
Rocky Garden.
Right.
Is that a river or and the red?
Looks
like a red carpet.
Red carpet.
Eli, where this will be? Where will your garden be? Eli.
I don't know.
Thinking. Thank you for sharing.
Thank you, Eli.
Again, wanna share?
Okay.
Again, you want to share? Okay. I don't have much progress yet, but I'm just gonna share. So I'm working on a collage here. I don't have any thought yet what my garden is going to be, but so I just call it colorful garden for now. So here the plan, my focal point will be the the what do you call this
one,
the rainbow
on. Oh
yeah, so this is gonna be a rainbow pool, and then after that, this side it's gonna be the grass area where people can have some picnic, and here I'm not sure yet. Yeah, so yeah, that's all from me, and yeah, I'm gonna work on that. For me, I like to play around with the different shapes. So yeah, biomorphic shape and yeah, geometric shape. Yeah.
Thank you. I like your college artwork. Like I'll see on your Instagram. Did you like have an exhibition on the US, like exhibition in like an art museum?
Yeah, in some of a gallery. So I basically right. So I previously I have done a numbers of collage. Yeah, most of the projects that the papers that I used was from I upcycled from the calendars that I collected or brochure, and then so I thought of, hey, there's an open call of art exhibition, why not just try? Yeah, and then I'm lucky to be selected, and yeah, it's currently in Florida, US. Yeah, there are three projects. Yeah. I personally feel that like, oh, this is like, you know, I'm doing upcycling. There was times that you feel that like, will people appreciate, you know, upcycling project, but yeah, you will find people that appreciate your project. So guys, don't give up on your project.
Yes. Yeah,
nice. Rina, would you like to share?
I'm not done yet.
So you wanna share the progress or later?
Later.
Okay, no worries.
Okay.
How about Candice, Sharon, and Ifaldo? Would you like to share your progress?
Later, me.
Later. Yeah.
Can we know what media that you use for your design?
May I share my artwork?
Yes, of course. Well. Yeah. Where is it?
It's my office. Inspired by my office aside. The square plane. Square garden. Gak jelas ya kalau di sini.
Yeah, bikin
this the boundaries of the side square. Mm-hmm. And then this area susah mirror.
Yeah, mirror.
Mirror. Bentar aku ganti dulu. Then watercolor. Yeah, watercolor. This the cage of the cat.
Cat.
The playground of the cat.
Cat.
Yeah, cat.
Kucing.
Yeah, kucing.
Cat in your office.
Yeah. My boss have many cats. And this is the yellow one. At the screen plane, you can see this. Not a climber plane. Apa kayak yang menjuntai gitu?
Climber plane.
Iya, tapi not climber. Yeah. And a sitting area is this is a sitting area.
And this is a focal point. There are upon koi fish.
Koi fish, yeah.
Yeah. Mm. This is the barrier and border plant.
Mm-hmm.
And then this is a border plant separate the pathway to make the pathway this from this to there. And then this the display plane, rocky areas like this one.
So the bottom one is the perspective.
Yeah, of this spot. At this spot. Difficult to. I think that enough for my atmosphere share.
Thank you, Ami.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So suppose that all of us have our site plan, right? Do you have any suggestion that how we can move forward with our plan?
Maybe you can apa ya? Make tentukan define what spot do you want to have in your area. After you have a site plan, like you have to define it. You already defined, oh, this is the pool, this is a walking area. You can make the perspective sketch. I think it's okay. Like, oh, what will be the sitting area or walking area looks like? Something like that.
Okay. So to show the 3D plans on how we
Yeah. Can be 3D model or like just sketch is also okay.
Okay,
and already upload in Padlet. This one is, I want to make this kind of garden in my house. This is the house building. My house has a very limited space. So yeah, this is the circulation and the garden area. So this one, oh yeah, aku lupa nulis. This one is, I want to make a garden in my house. Well, however, the space is too limited. So I make a climber plan in this section X and Y. This is the X section, and in the Y section, A section, I also plants. A plant in the pot. It's a mint tomato, and this side is the chili plants. Why? Because I love making pasta, so I need the ingredients quickly, so I don't have to go to the supermarket. So I hope I can get the ingredients directly from my garden, like this mint leaf and the tomato, also a little bit of chili. So yeah, this is the plan in the Y section. This is also the climber plan is Siri. I didn't know the English name. Siri is also like a medicine plant from, well, maybe in the Southeast Asia, we can find them easily. Yeah, and then in the X section, I want to grow vines like tanaman, apa ya, climber plant who has a flower.
Okay.
Yeah, this is my garden in my limited space.
So it's outside. Okay. Wait, how about this side? This is top view, sorry. Okay.
So this is a house building.
Okay. Yeah. Thanks so much once again to join us in this special moment with Klub Hobi. So before everybody go, would you mind to, you know, just off your on your camera, let's take a nice picture together, and then I think yes.
1, 2, 3. Okay.
Yeah, thank you, Junka.
Thank you, Junka.
Thank you once again, Irina, Erin, Ken. Yeah. You're looking forward to see what you're doing.
Yeah, we are looking forward to see your garden.
And Eli also continue to work on your project. So I believe that you have fun today. So we hope to see everyone again in the sessions.
If you want, we can share our garden in Instagram. So yeah, kan kak, pengen lihat karya-karya teman-teman.
Yeah. Oh, so right. They would like to request everybody to have a screenshot of your or a photo of your project, and they would like to feature us on Instagram. So I'm gonna chase you guys. please submit some project. That's your homework. Take your time. Maybe during the weekend, if you have nothing to do, feel free to do. Okay. So thank you once again.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Have a good weekend. Enjoy your lunch. Bye, Candice. Bye, Erin.
Bye, Candice. Bye, Arena. Bye, Eli. Bye, Egan. Bye, Clarine.
Thank you for joining
us. Thank you. Hope to see you again.